BJP leader LK Advani admitted in his blog that BJP's defeat in Karnataka was no surprise to him and that he would have been surprised if the party had won. "I feel sorry that we have lost in Karnataka, but I am not surprised. The surprise would have been if we had won," he said. He also pointed out that the results of Karnataka elections are a profound lesson for the BJP as well as the Congress. "As it is, I think the Karnataka results have a profound lesson for the BJP. In a way, it has a lesson also for the Congress. The common lesson for both of us is, let's not take the common man for granted. The common man himself may occasionally deviate from the norms of ethical conduct, but he does not feel extremely angry when he sees those at the helm of national affairs behaving immorally. This is the principal reason why there is such intense allergy towards politicians generally nowadays," he said. Commenting on the UPA, he said the indignation that corruption provoked in Bangalore was being reflected in New Delhi too. "If corruption provokes indignation in Bangalore, why would it not cause the same feeling in New Delhi? Actually, I hold that it is the Karnataka results that have contributed to clinching action being taken even in the matter of Colgate and Railgate. Before Karnataka results, the Congress party seemed determined not to do anything about the two scams, even if it meant a total washout of the second half of the budget session," he said. He also referred to Yediyurappa in the blog and said that things would have been different if BJP had taken appropriate action on time. Citing examples of previous political situations in other states wherein the BJP had taken a strong stand against its own people, he concluded, "Because of the high expectations we have aroused in the people by our excellent track record in all these years, even minor discretions can prove costly for us. And our response to the Karnataka crisis was not at all a minor discretion. I have consistently maintained that our handling of Karnataka has been absolutely opportunistic." With the Pakistan Muslim League establishing an insurmountable lead over other parties in the Pakistan National Assembly, the interest was primarily on who would emerge runner-up, Pakistan People's Party or cricketer-turned-politician Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf. The PML leadership met in Lahore while waiting the formal announcement of results. Party head and Prime Minister-designate Nawaz Sharif. The PML leadership met in Lahore while awaiting the formal announcement of results, party head and Prime Minister-designate Nawaz Sharif reiterated his victory speech in which he said that his attempt would be to carry all political parties with him. Many political analysts see PML's performance in these elections as a repeat of its 1998 performance and are keeping their fingers crossed for the party in its third attempt at ruling the country. N. Prakash will be back in Dakshina Kannada as its deputy commissioner consequent upon the transfer of present incumbent Harsh Gupta. Earlier, Prakash was transferred prior to the elections and now that the elections are over, he has been re-transferred. The transfers were made as per the directions of the election commission. Harsh Gupta, present DC, will be back in Bangalore as labour commissioner as a post he had held prior to becoming the labour minister. Earlier, the Election Commission had transferred 12 officers of KAS cadre who were serving as deputy commissioners and had replaced them by direct IAS recruits. Consequent upon this, the KAS promoters had moved the Central Administrative Tribunal and had stayed the transfers. A hotelier from Udupi was killed in a hit-and-run case in front of Grace Auditorium at Tekkatte. The deceased is 45 years Kushal Shetty of Kiradi near Mandarti. Eyewitnesses said the vehicle sped in the cover of darkness as soon as Kushal Shetty collapsed on the road. He is survived by his wife and two children. Ironically, tragedy struck the family a day before its housewarming ceremony. Kota police have registered a case. Once again, the main headlines. Siddaramaiah Sonin as chief minister left Delhi to shortlist the cabinet. Congress government in state still minority in legislative council. BJP's defeat in Karnataka true, a lesson to Congress at one. Third term Pakistan Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif won the poll. Prakash back in Dakshina Kannada Deputy Commissioner. Hit and run case in NH66 hotelier killed at Tekkatte. This is all in this edition. For more news, keep watching V4 News 24/7, or you may also log on to v4news.com.